Francis, Anasina, and Pesara hope to continue their season of firsts. The flamboyant French team remain undefeated after winning their first European championship, and they're also the favorites to win their first world gold. Fellow Europeans lead the chase for the podium. Fucipoli and Margaglio compete for the first ice dance world medal in Italian history. Another surprise this year, Lithuanians, Drobiazko and Vanagas won a bronze medal at Europeans. And the Russians, Lobacheva and Averbuch, hope to improve on their fourth place finishes in the last two world championships. Two-time defending U.S. champions Lang and Chernyshev lead the Americans, and the U.S. silver medalists Silverstein and Piquera compete at Senior Worlds for the first time. The original dance is next. Back inside the Palais des Expositions here in the center of Nice, France, our coverage of the 2000 World Figure Skating Championships continues now, and we turn our attention to ice dance. Hi again, everybody. I'm Terry Gannon. The ladies will be out there on the ice in just a little bit with their short programs, but right now, it's the original dance, the second of three phases for the ice dancers here in Nice. And we welcome in the two-time U.S. ice dancing champion, Susie Wynn. What about the original dance? What's it all about?
Well, Terry, as you explained to me, golf on Saturdays is considered moving day. And really, this phase of the competition, the original dance, is considered the moving day for ice dancing. That is, it's a three-minute Latin rhythm program with required elements, and it counts for 30% of the overall score. But what we're going to see is some shifting and some ties being broken. Moving day.
Well, no one should be surprised to hear that the last eight world championships in ice dancing have been won by Russians. Well, the reigning world champs from Russia, Krylov and Ovsyannikov, they've been out all season long. They have not competed because of an injury. So the overwhelming favorites here in France, the French team, Marina Anasina and Gwendal Pesara.
Well, they've dominated all season, Terry. They have won every event they've participated in, but they might get a little challenge from the Italians, Barbara Fusarpoli and Maurizio Margaglio, who have had a lot of success in their original dance. And at the European Championships just recently, they were able to receive three first place scores from the judges. So it could be a little bit of a challenge.
It'd be fun to watch the Americans, too. It always is. But here, there are a couple of young teams starting to leave their mark in Nice.
They are. Lang and Chernyshev, the U.S. dance champions, are tied in eighth place. I think they'll move up in this original dance. And also, the newcomers, new kids on the block, Silverstein and Piquerec, they're in a respectable 14th place. It's a strong field, and hopefully we'll see that moving day happen.
Well, right now, the standings after the compulsory dances. Anasina Pesara in the lead, as expected, then the Italians. The Russians, Lobacheva and Averbuch, they're in third. And in terms of the Americans, you mentioned, Susie, Lang and Chernyshev tied for eighth right now. And Silverstein and Piquerec, the young team, they're in 14th. So the original dance gets underway, and here are the U.S. silver medalists. Not only their first season at the Senior World Championships, their first season competing on the senior level. Jamie Silverstein, Justin Piquerec.
This young team is so great at is bridging the required elements and making them fun and entertaining. This is the circular footwork pattern. They have tremendous holds, some very intricate footwork. If you look at their feet, constant movement and very intricate. One thing that's been great about ice dancing this year is there's vocal music allowed in both the free dance and here in the original dance, unlike all the other disciplines.
How much of a difference does that make for the skaters?
Well, it really offers a variety for certain. And the skaters are having a great time with the OD, the original dance, because Latin music right now is so hot.
'99 World Junior Champions with 3 minutes here to try to move up from 14th place.
This skating, you'll hear us talk about edges. Right here, you can see deep curves where the blade is at a deep angle. It shows so much control and just great skating ability. They really held their own in practices here and earlier in the compulsory dance. Straight line footwork pattern looking for unison. Complicated turns called twizzles. Another great performance. I have not seen these two have a rough one all year. They're spectacular.
Well, in ice dance, you see skaters older than the other disciplines. Late 20s, early 30s even. Jamie Silverstein only 16 years of age and Justin Pekarek 18 years old.
And they handle all their pressure like real pros. And here in their circular footwork, watch how close they are. Their feet are very close. Both of them have very complicated footwork. They're changing positions side to side. They do this just as well as anyone. In the straight line sequence, you're allowed to do one or two revolution turns and half jumps, what are called half jumps, looking for unison, and they can only be two handholds apart.
5-1, 5-0. Now remember, this original dance worth 30% of the overall score. Two sets of marks, the first for composition. And there they are.
Well, Terry, that 4.4 is awfully low considering this is a very complicated and beautifully choreographed program.
And now the marks for presentation. 4.7 up to 5.2. So the effort here in the original dance for Silverstein and Pekarek, the U.S. silver medalists. The German champions who are next, Kati Winkler and René Lose in fifth place, coming into the original dance. Here at the World Championships, the original dance continues now with the four-time and reigning German national champions. They finished fifth at this season's Europeans, Kati Winkler and René Lose.
Strong opening to the samba.
Steady rise up the ranks in the world of ice dancing as it normally happens. 19th at Worlds back in 95, but 7th last season.
That's a big jump.
And 5th heading into this original dance here in Nice.
Well-matched couple. They have great partnering skills. And in practices here, they've really won the hearts of the audience.
Much different look, too, than Silverstein and Pekarek, the young Americans. And The German team here with much more experience, Susie.
That's true. You can see a little bit of that experience coming out in their strength and their approach. There's nothing like experience. Being on the ice with the best skaters in the world, you have a mature quality that Silverstein and Pekarek are still working on. Creating a fun mood. Latin music is fun, it's exciting and expressive, and they do all of those things.
And we mentioned their experience. They've been together for almost 12 years now. In fifth place, hoping for their best finish yet at the World Championships, at least a top five finish here in Nice. Kati Winkler and René Lose.
One thing that I really appreciate about this team is just how well they lift. Here you can see a nice change of position. They skate very close together and have great flow in and out of all of their dance lifts. And here in their final lift, lots of changes of position, strength, and flexibility. These lifts take a long time to learn. In fact, you have to take a lot of time on the floor to really time them well.
So now their marks in the first set for composition in the 5.3 to 5.5 range.
Well, some solid marks for a very solid performance.
Yeah, they're excited about it. Looks like they're happy. Presentation marks 5.4 up to 5.6. Yep. Very happy about it. Winkler and Lose in the lead, but a lot of skating yet to come here in the original dance. When we come back, Arina Lobacheva and Ilya Averbuch, the Russian hopes rest on their shoulders here at the World Championships. They'll take the ice next. Back in Nice, the World Figure Skating Championships continue now, the original dance. And here are Arina Lobacheva and Ilya Averbuch of Russia. 1968 was the last time a Russian team did not medal at the World Championships in ice dance. They're trying to continue the streak.
The approach, everything with great energy in this samba. They're both equally matched in their performance abilities and in their technical abilities.
Really been on the verge of breaking through to stand on the podium the past couple of years. They finished fourth at the last two World Championships, watching their countryman, Golovin Ovsyannikov, win gold.
These are a lot of hard connections. As they begin their rumba, which is a sultry dance. I had a chance to really sit down and talk with Irina and Ilya, and they really feel the pressure this year, Terry. They said it's been hard finding music and making the right choices. They've had some injuries. And you could just see there's a little bit of insecurity during practices and during some of their performances here.
nice unison on their turns. Considering all the pressure that's on them to keep that third place position, I thought that this was one of the best performances so far in the competition.
Probably as good as we've seen them all year long. Tough to turn that snowball effect around, too. Their programs early in the season were not well received. You mentioned the injuries. Arena had a shoulder injury, but skating very well right now here in Nice. Arena Lobacheva and Ilya Averbuch.
They have some nice choreography here in this somersault lift. They incorporated it very well into their choreography. And again, keep the things moving, which is nice. Straight line footwork. You can see here their unison is terrific as they go into their twizzles and turns. Well done.
Irina and Ilya have been married for some 3 years. Ilya, the former partner of Marina Anasinu, now skates with Gwendal Pézerat from France, the overwhelming favorites here. First set of marks for composition, 5.5 to 5.8.
Well, you definitely get the sense that the judges are pleased with the composition and are really pushing them into that third place.
And now the presentation marks, those are very good too. Lobacheva Averbuch into the lead. Well, right now Leslie Visser is standing by with one of their countrymen, a world champion who wishes she could skate out here in Nice. Leslie?
Terry, two-time world champion Angelika Krylova has some difficult decisions to make. Angelika, first of all, how are you?
Thank you. I feel much better. I start skate 1 month ago. My partner wait me. I'm so happy for this too. I come back to Delaware and we start work. It's difficult to do, to tell what's going on later, but I just try. I hope everything fine.
But right now you actually have quite a serious problem in your neck.
Yes, it's a very serious problem because many people just don't understand what is it. But for me, it's hard to explain to English what's going on. It's not just disc. It's too much, I don't know, more serious problem, you know.
Can you risk paralysis if you continue to skate?
Yeah, the doctor tell, yes, the doctor don't, even no one doctor tell me I can skate anymore. But depends how I feel. I don't feel pain, I skate. I feel pain, I think I try to do something else.
Could you have surgery to correct the problem?
No, if I make surgery, you see right here, because they need cut, right, my neck, everything. I do some metallic, I don't know, something. So it's a difficult surgery, and I think I don't want to do this.
Do you have to consider retiring?
What does it mean?
To not skate anymore?
I don't decide yet. I try to skate. I decide to try skate. I talking with my partner, with my coach. They want to help me a lot. They're afraid to save me. And I see everything depends me how I feel. I want to skate. For me, it's very hard to stay here and watch how people skate, how compete. I feel so different, you know.
Yes. Well, good luck. We hope to see you back on the ice. Thank you, Angelika. Back to you, Terry.
Coming up next, Naomi Lang and Peter Chernyshev, the two-time and reigning U.S. champions. Last-minute preparations before they take the ice here in Nice.
Naomi Lang and Peter Chernyshev.
Moving day for the ice dancers here at the World Figure Skating Championships, and now we see if the American champions can make a move. In eighth place after the compulsories, Naomi Lang and Peter Chernyshev.
Peter and Naomi are just excellent dancers and excellent skaters, and it shows in everything that they do. One thing I love about their straight line sequence is the speed and the approach and their turns, and they're not just turning once, they're doing double turns here, double twizzles, and their unison is picture perfect.
They've already improved on what they did last year at Worlds. top 10 finish. Right now they're in eighth. Recently won their second straight U.S. title in Cleveland. And they got the first perfect six of their careers.
Their original dance choreographed by Igor Spielbaum, their coach. From the required elements, the dancers are also able to create some of their own specialty moves. This is a hydroblading move. Beautiful. This program is much more difficult and laid out better than some of the free dances, or rather the original dances that are placed ahead of them. Well, that was great energy. They skated that with their hearts. And you just see the confidence is finally coming through.
Starting to get the recognition, too, from the judges on the international scene. Their first major international win at the Four Continents Championships after they won their second straight national title. Last year, 10th at Worlds, right now 8th, so they are making a move. Naomi Lang, Peter Chernyshev.
And you can really see their beautiful skating skill here in this dance lift. Watch Peter's feet. They're so neat, very clear and concise. She is able to create great shapes through her leg line. Beautiful flow, again, going in and out. And some of the moves that they've come up with are just truly extraordinary. Here, the balance, the relationship in their shape, beautiful. And the energy, you could just see Naomi. This is the happiest I've seen her. It was so hard to be on the warm-up with Anissina and Pesera. They've really, really have been rising to the occasion.
5-2, 5-1, 5-2. Looks like Peter's been laying on the beach here in Nice. Got the suntan working here as he awaits the marks. Composition, oh, that's a wide range. 5.0, the low mark, Susie.
Well, the recognition that you're talking about, Terry, is not spreading out to all of the judges, unfortunately. Those are very low. 5-1s and 5-2s really don't make any sense.
And with the presentation marks, Lang and Chernyshev into fourth place overall, and you can tell they're disappointed with that. Coming up, Margarita Drobiazko and Povilas Vanagas, the team from Lithuania. They have hopes of standing on the podium here at the World Championships. A reminder, the World Figure Skating Championships continue all weekend with the ladies' primetime coverage Saturday night beginning at 9 p.m. Eastern on ABC Sports. Then Sunday, over on ABC Sports as well, the men's championship beginning at 1 p.m. Eastern. ABC, ESPN, and ESPN2, your home for the World Figure Skating Championships. Well, on the ice here at the Palais des Expositions, here's where things get interesting in that battle for the bronze medal. From Lithuania, Margarita Drobiazko and Povilas Vanagas.
I would say in the original dance and in the free dance, this is where they really shine. They have a tremendous freedom of movement as they start off in this rumba.
is another team on the move. They finished sixth at the World Championships last season, won the bronze medal recently at Europeans, and they're trying to keep the Russians, Lobachev and Averbuch, off the podium here.
Both teams are very well matched, but Drabiosko and Vanagas have really had a lot of success this season, winning their first international at Skate Canada, and it just seems to keep building from there. A dance spin. This is called cross Killian position.
Important to keep in mind how wide open things are for some of these dance teams this season. Without Krylovanov, Sionikov, the reigning world champs, and without Born and Kratz from Canada, who have been meddling. So two of the top teams out. Great opportunity.
Well, it certainly takes you up two notches very quickly.
Right.
It's so unusual. Exceptional performance. You could feel the audience. They were really getting into it as well. Tremendous performers.
Margarita Drobiazko and Povilas Vanagas, the man who at one point in his life was given the option, skate or go into the Soviet Army. Well, you see the choice, the one that most of us would have picked. In fourth, trying to move up here with the effort in the original dance.
Here in their circular footwork pattern, they do a tremendous job of creating intricate dance holds. And you can see the feet. They're not just stepping. They are moving on edges and trying to continue the flow. Excellent. And here in their dance spin, it must turn three revolutions. They have a nice center and great speed in the cross Killian position.
Margarita, who is from Moscow but has moved to Lithuania, so Povilas can skate for Lithuania. Now, will they move ahead of the Russians? First set, Susan.
Doesn't look like it, Terry. Some of these marks are a little bit low. Their original dance was a little bit more difficult than that of Lobachev and Averbuch.
And presentation marks, pretty wide range, 5.5 up to 5.9, so that is not enough. Drobiazko Vanagas in the second behind Lobacheva and Averbuch. We'll come back to see if Barbara Fuster-Poli and Maurizio Morgaglio of Italy can threaten for the lead here in Nice. That when we return to the World Figure Skating Championships. The original dance continues here at the World Figure Skating Championships in Nice. Can the Italians challenge the French here on the French Riviera? We find that out right now, at least the first part of it. Barbara Fuster-Poli and Maurizio Morgaglio in second place after the compulsory dances.
Yeah, some very authentic ballroom passes, or arm holds as they call them. They're very comfortable in this role of the Latin combination. Yeah.
ladies take the ice for their short programs in just a little bit. Tomorrow night, the free skate, when a champion will be crowned over on ABC in primetime at 9 o'clock Eastern. And the finals of the ice dancing competition, along with the pairs, April 8th, over on ABC. That's a Saturday afternoon.
Difficult balance, hydroblading move. The tension in the arms has to be just right to pull that off. And they really start getting flow and accelerating before they go into their final, one of their final elements. Straight line footwork, great speed, great attack. Great last lift, that is so tricky. That was a strong performance, Terry. You could tell they were forcing it a little bit because it's everything's on the line right now, but this has really suited them all year long.
Fifth in the world last season in Helsinki, but they can expect much better than that this season because of the teams that are out and because they've gotten that much better since then. From Italy, Barbara Fusserpoli and Maurizio Margaglio.
Now, we throw that word around a lot, hydroblading, but it's a skimming of the blade really close to the ice. And the arms are creating the tension in the hold. That's very difficult, and it takes a lot of time to get the balance right. And their final lift, it's small and it's quick, but it's tricky. Here, she just interlaces in between his arm. That's close range. And again, lots of work. Good stuff.
Even though they've done it so many times this season, gotta feel good to come out here and perform at the World Championships when everything is on the line. First set, 5.7 to 5.9.
Well, that's so hard to get up for this and make sure that you're consistent with the rest of the year. Some of these marks are nice, 5.7, a little low.
A little bit excited there, too, about the presentation marks. 5.7 in all 5.9s, except for that one mark. Fusserpoli and Margaglio into the lead.
The French judge, Terry.
Well, the crowd noise, it's already started to build. Marina Anasina and Gwendal Pézera, the European champions from France, take the ice next. Fusserpoli and Margaglio into the lead right now. Molbacheva and Averbuch from Russia second, and Joviasco and Vonnegut. That's your top three. No one in this audience cares about that, though. They've got the French team on the ice. Marina Anasina and Gwendal Pézera.
Working off that great energy from the audience.
Marina originally from Moscow, but she does have French citizenship now. They live and train in Lyon, which is not far from here.
They've made a music change from Europeans. So obviously they were taking care of business, making sure that they secure their position as leaders in this original dance. Nice unison in their leg line here in the dance spin. Change of foot is permitted.
A standing ovation here on the French Riviera for the five-time French national champions. Last 2 years, they've been the world silver medalists, trying for the top spot here at home. And the overwhelming favorites to do just that. And we just got hit by some of the flowers. It is raining flowers in this building.
And some problems here in the straight line footwork for Gwendal. Watch his left foot. He misaligns. You can see the foot is not underneath his hip. His feet separate, and they lose their alignment together. That's what the judges are watching for, unison and individual skill. This is an area that he struggled with all year. But Marina, look at this attitude. She's got it. She can be very intimidating, feisty, and hot.
So let's see what the judges think now, because you had said earlier in the evening that you felt maybe that the Italians had a better original dance than the French team. This crowd doesn't agree with you, but we'll see. Composition 5.7 to 5.9. And now the presentation marks in the 5.8, in fact 5.7 up to 5.9. Should be 5.8, 5.9, but Susie, that's not good enough. Fusciopoli and Margaglio in the lead right now. That's a shock.
And this might be the reason why, Terry, in the straight line footwork, they really were off unison, not getting in all of their turns earlier in the program. And you can see here they're not really next to each other. But I can't believe my prediction was right.
Well, you were right. Take it for what it's worth. But I think they're shocked. I think everyone in this building right now shocked that the French aren't in the lead, no matter what you think about their original dance. Susie, you called it moving day, the biggest move of all. Fusciopoli and Margaglio ahead of Anasina and Pesara going into the free dance. Lobachev and Averbuch keeping the Russian hopes alive for a medal in third. And the Americans, Lang and Chernyshev, a solid eighth. Silverstein and Pekarik move up a spot to 13th. Right now, Leslie Visser is joined by a very disappointed Anasina and Pesara. Leslie?
Terry, another powerful performance from the homeboys, but not exactly what they would have wanted, probably. Gwendal, can you talk a little bit about the straight line footwork?
Yeah, actually, we accept this little stumble here.
What happened?
I can't really tell. It's kind of, you know, like I was really good on the old dance, feel great, and it's just like something, things happen, you know, we're human, so we're not like machines. And actually, we did it very well. The rest of the dance was good, and it's a very technical dance, so anything can happen.
It happens, one little slip. But talk about what the crowd did for you. How great was that?
I think we have a little bit more pressure because of that, because it's in our home and public. They won't see our best results, but I'm not afraid about today, about this result, because we can see we did little mistakes, and tomorrow it will be changed. It will be another day.
Absolutely. You both look ready to claim your first world title. Thank you both. Back to you, Terry.
Leslie, thank you. We'll see Anasina and Pesarad try to come back with a free dance along with the Paris Free Skate, April 8th over on ABC Sports. Not done yet tonight, though. Up next, the ladies. Michelle Kwan going for title number 3. Maria Butyrskaya trying to repeat. Arina Slutskaya back with a vengeance. The ladies' short program is next.